Hey guys, it's the last job of the week. I'm doing two rooms and some stairs, and it's white carpet with dog urine in it. So let me get an instructional video. I'm gonna kind of take you through what I usually do and what I've got mixed for the pre-spray on this particular one. So hang on here, I'm gonna turn the camera around and we'll go over that. I'm gonna be using the Challenger on this here, these two rooms. And we use Oric on the stairs. And I've gotten some peroxide on my finger here, so to get that to stinging so bad, you go ahead and rinse it off. Okay, and here, what I've got is a stronger mix of hydrogen peroxide and not so much Simple Green, because it's not dirt, it's urine that I'm working with here. And I've got a pretty good shot of what I use sometimes is Fabuloso, because it's a non-rinsing product and it smells really good. It smells like green apples. This is 20% peroxide and this is straight ammonia. So what you want to do in the areas where you know there's urine, before you pre-spray the carpet, you treat those areas here so it can start to bleach it out. And this is also good for if there's like anything else in the carpet that's organic, like if there's dog poo or whatever, or urine, you put that in there before you start so it can break it down. So all around here, I'm going to be spraying this into the carpet. Then I'm going to work it in with my foot, and then I will pre-spray the carpet. It's important that you have enough dwell time on this to do what it's going to do. And also the other part, when you run the machine over it, the way peroxide works is that when you heat it, it activates it and it makes it work better. By heating it, it activates it and makes it a stronger biological bleaching solution, basically. So you run the machine over it a little longer, and you can add more if you can, if you want to, and it will help to bleach it out more. The only way you could ever damage carpet with peroxide, synthetic fibers basically, that is if you were to poke a hole in the jug of peroxide and let it drain slowly into the carpet and have it stay wet for about 2 or 3 weeks, that is possible to do it like that. Otherwise, you're fine. I even use it. I won't tell you to use it on organic fibers, but I do. And I've never had any issues with it, but it is possible to damage organic fibers like wool or anything like that. I would never clean a silk rug at all. I would just pass. Because most of what I do is, well, I mean, I could. I'm just not. Luckily, I never run into that. All right, I'm going to finish treating this, and then I'll spray it, and I'll show some of the cleaning here. I'm going to start. Alright, I've already done this side here and it's been groomed. I'll take another look at it here in a little bit. This side here, I'm getting ready to clean. I added an extra step to this job. When I sprayed it, I groomed everything in. I groomed the cleaner through the fibers with the Grandy groomer here. Very tired here. Alright, now I'm going to run the machine over here. careful not to slip down. The tile is very slippery when your feet are wet. Now, clean the carpet. All of this is a little harder than one-handed holding the camera here. Catch back up shortly here. All right, what's been done here is I sprayed the stairs, and then I, like I said, while I groomed the cleaner through the fibers, and now I'm going to clean it with the Oric, and I'm not going to be able to catch a bit of that because it'll take two hands to run this thing. So when I get done, I will show you what it looks like when I finish. The Oric, I find out that I like the hand tool that I use, that I've always used for the stairs, but I like the way the Oric. I feel like it's more absorbent. There's a lot more dirt you can hold in this, and not have to. A lot of times I'll stop and I'll spray the pad with ammonia and clean it out about halfway through the stairs if I feel like it's getting full, so you can take on more dirt. All right, I'm gonna clean this direction going down the stairs. So I'll show you when I'm finished. See if I can show a little bit of this here. It's something I haven't shown yet. Again, one-handed, a little hard like this. Working really well. I'm liking this because I'm able to stand up and work rather than bend over and break my back. Most of the time when you finish stairs, when you go to stand up, it hurts very bad because you've been bent over for 15 minutes or however long it takes, 20 minutes, sometimes 30 minutes to clean with the other tool. So this one, I found a way now to do this while standing. All right, I'm going to I got to get the cord out of my own way, so I'm going to quit recording here for a second, and I will show you when I'm done. All right, here we're done freshly cleaning these stairs here. It turned out really well, and as I say, when it's dry, it will be about 10% whiter. See, everything's all fluffy, and you always want to groom this stuff. I mean, you groom carpet all the time, but it's especially important with a carpet fiber like this. Does you stand it up, it allows air to get around the fiber and makes it dry faster. And also in this particular type of carpet, you want to groom the cleaner end before you clean it, so you get better results when you do that. All right, there we go. Hate to step on my own stuff. This is the end of my work week for me. It's awfully hot and sweaty out here. It's been raining all week in Austin, so now the sun came out, and it's just humid, wet, and nasty feeling outside. All right, appreciate you watching the video. If you have questions, you can always call or text 512-350-1129. God bless.